السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل الله فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, today's khutbah is about wisdom of trials and tribulations and reward of patience. We will learn some wisdoms and rewards of patience through a story which is mentioned in the Holy Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions a story in the Surah Al-Kahf. That story occurred between Khizr alayhi salam and Musa alayhi salam. Surah Al-Kahf is a surah which we most of us frequently read, especially on Friday. And we can benefit many things from the Surah Al-Kahf, especially from this story. So now, who is Khizr alayhi salam? Khizr actually is not mentioned, the name Khizr is not mentioned in the Holy Quran. It's from Hadith. Many of scholars agreed that Khizr alayhi salam was a prophet and he was sent at the time of Musa alayhi salam but different places. So the story is as follows. One day Musa alayhi salam was giving a khutbah to his people and one of the people asked Musa alayhi salam who is the most knowledgeable person on earth. So Musa alayhi salam assumed that he is the most knowledgeable person. Why not? I mean, after all, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala directly spoken to Musa alayhi salam, and he is one of the mightiest prophets. Also, he had the largest ummah up until his time. So he assumed it and he informed the people that, yes, I am the most knowledgeable person. So immediately Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down Jibreel to Musa alayhi salam and informed him, O Musa, how could you speak without knowledge? Verily, there is a servant of ours, that means Khizr. We have given him knowledge that you don't have. So Musa alayhi salam humbled himself. and ask permission from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to meet Khidr and seek knowledge from him. So Allah allows him and gives him some signs. So eventually Musa alayhi salam meet Khidr and he asked Khidr alayhi salam, let me follow you so that I can learn some of your knowledge. Khidr says, you don't have enough patience to be with me. Musa alayhi salam said, you will find me among the patients, inshallah. And then Khidr alayhi salam said, okay, if this is the case, then I have only one condition. If you accompany me, don't ask me any questions until I explain to you. I have a mission. I'll explain to you, but don't ask me, don't interfere me with me. So Musa alayhi salam agreed, and they were walking, and they found a ship which belonged to some poor fishermen. So Musa and Khidr alayhi salam needed to cross the other side of the river, and they asked fishermen, would you carry us to the other side? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would reward you. We don't have enough money. So the fishermen were generous and they agreed. So the fishermen went there, were casting their net and fishing. Khidr alayhi salam comes down to the into the hull of the ship and pulls out an axe and he cracks the hull of the ship. Just enough to, you know, allow the water come in, and by this time they can get to the safety without drowning. So the fishermen, you know, confusing where is this water coming from, Musa and Khidr alayhi salam disappeared. So as soon as this incident happened, Musa alayhi salam said that, how could you have done this to the people when they were more generous to us? Khidr alayhi salam said, didn't I tell you, you don't have enough patience? Musa alayhi salam said, I forgot. Actually, he genuinely forgot this time. So Musa alayhi salam then promised that I won't do this again. While Musa alayhi salam just promised, the freshly promised, you know, that I won't ask you anything further, they were walking, you know, on the shore, and there are some people, you know, playing kids, you know, kids playing on the shore, and then Khidr alayhi salam took one of the kids and he killed instantly. You know, despite Musa alayhi salam, you know, he just promised, and then another incident happened. Especially, you know, killing an innocent life, and especially if it is a child, it is a big deal. So Musa alayhi salam was so frustrated and angry, and he asked Khidr alayhi salam that, how could you have taken an innocent life? Khidr alayhi salam said that, look, didn't I tell you you don't have any patience with me? So Musa alayhi salam, actually, this time he didn't forget. So he didn't have an excuse. So other than so, he said that, okay, give me one more chance, one more last try. If I do it again, then we'll go our ways. At this point, our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that, may Allah have mercy on Musa. Had he not been hasty and put that condition himself, he would have seen many amazing things. Also, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that, hastiness is from shaitan, and thinking and acting calmly is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So there's a lesson for us. So two of them make their way to village, where, remember, they are hungry, they have been, you know, working for a long time, hungry, and they don't have enough money. They don't have even any money to buy food. But there was a tradition at that time, in fact this is the tradition of our time as well. So if a stranger comes to a town, and the stranger deserves to have some, minimum hospitality from the town, community. But these town people were so miserly and stingy that they didn't even offer a glass of water or a, you know, piece of bread. Not only that, they ridiculed and they mocked Musa and Khidr alayhi salam, and get rid of them and drove out of the city. And then as they walked out, remember Musa alayhi salam was quite frustrated. He has seen two incidents that is, you know, against his conceptions. So also on top of the ridiculous behavior from the town people. So while they were walking back, you know, out of the town, and Kizrasim stopped and he saw almost a falling wall. And then he went there and he repairs the wall and put it in farm conditions. And then, you know, Musa was quite frustrated and hungry, and then Kizrasim repairs their wall. So the wall is actually town wall, it's part of the town wall. And then Musa said to the Kizrasim, the least you could have done is to get some food for what you have done. You have repaired the wall, that's fine, but at least you can ask some food or some money in return of what you have done. Khidr al-Salam says to Musa, this is the third condition, you put this condition yourself, now we'll go our ways. But before we go, I shall tell you what you had no patience to understand. So, Khidr al-Salam explains to Musa, as for the sheep of the fishermen, the sheep belonged to a group of people, and there was a tyrannical queen in that area. He was confiscating every single usable sheep of that area. So there must be, you know, maybe any war going on with neighbor countries, so the king wants to, you know, strengthen his naval forces by confiscating other ships. So, by putting this hole to this ship, the poor fisherman's ship, and then king comes and will find that the ship is not in usable conditions, it's damaged, he will, you know, overlook it. So Kizi said, by putting the damage in the ship, I in fact saved the ship for the poor people. Now move on to the second incident, that is the death of child. SubhanAllah, every parents, every human being in fact, know that the most traumatic and the most, you know, painful things could happen to a human is the death of a child. So can you imagine, you know, the pain and suffering, you know, from those parents who would have felt that on the day they received the news of their, you know, child has been killed by completely, you know, a stranger without any reason. So Khidr al-Salam explains that their parents, I mean, those two people, that means the parents of that killed child, actually righteous people. They are mu'minin. They are good people and believers in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knew that if the child would grow up, he would have a spiritually dead heart. He would be the height of disobedience to his parents, and arrogant, you know, ungrateful, and continuously, you know, belittling and stabbing his parents. And in fact, this is the worst scenario than death of a child. So what did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala do? He just says, your Lord wanted that he substitute this child for a better child. To give a better child that shall be good to his parents and loyal and will be a believer as well. So the parents, they had a child with sweet memories, but potentially no future. But Allah now substitute with a child who will have good memories, you know, in the childhood time, and also in future, which is in Akhirah. The final incident, Kizi told to the Musa alayhi salam, the portion of the wall is behind a garden which belongs to two orphans, and their father was a righteous man. The father has died in early death, and before he died, he buried some treasures, which is, you know, happened to be under the wall. So if the wall fell down, and then treasures will be revealed. So remember the town people, they are so miserly and stingy, they didn't even offer a cup of, you know, water. So do you think if they got those treasures, and they will give it back to these orphans? Of course not. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Khidr al-Salam said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered him, and I repaired the wall until the orphans become strong men so that they can defend themselves. And frankly, when you need the treasures or the money, is it at the child age or the old age? You need the money, the treasures, when you are young, you are responsible for caring some people, so you have to, you know, do business. So this is the most, you know, peak time you need money. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala delay, you know, by repairing this wall, Allah delay that the orphans get those treasures when they need them, needed it most. أقول قول هذا واستغفر الله ولكم ولسائر المسلمين واستغفره إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. Brothers and sisters in Islam, we can learn many things from this story. First, the lesson from the sheep and the poor fishermen. Look, we haven't, you know, given much information about those fishermen, but one thing we know for sure from the Quran, that is, they were generous. After all, they, you know, let the people ride for free, despite they are poor. And so what did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala do? They showed their generosity through sheep. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preserved their vehicle of the generosity. So if you want, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put barakah in your wealth, your money, your time and health. So please, brothers and sisters, I impress you and myself as well to spend our whatever we have for the sake of Allah. And Allah will preserve what we have like He preserved the fishermanship. Also notice, brothers and sisters, can you imagine the frustration that the fishermen would have felt when they saw their ship had been damaged? Can you imagine their anger they would have felt when they realized those two people we put on the ship for free, they are the people who caused this damage, made this damage. So now imagine, when they see the king, tyrannical king, is confiscating their relatives, their neighbors, every single usable ships on that area, except their ship. Now, imagine how their frustration will instantaneously flip over to what? They will say, Alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down, you know, someone to make damage to this ship. But look at their frustration at the first place. They don't realize what is going to happen in, you know, like 5 minutes time or 10.